You're watching Fox 5 News at 5.
Former champion runner who ended up an addict is now focused on just putting one foot in front of the other.
Wes Salzberg is here with more on his long road to recovery. This is a very inspiring story.
Yeah, interesting guy, Darren, Steve. The first time I met the man that I'm about to introduce you folks to was roughly 16 years ago. He is a world-class runner, unfortunately. Along with that, he also has a world-class problem. This is Frank Shiro at his home away from home, the track at 6th Street in the FDR Drive. Now 63 years of age, Frank is a Masters champion in the 200, 400, 4x200 relay, 4x400 relay, and sprint medley, having owned at one time 6 world records. So, as we're here running on a track now, what's going through your mind?
Russ, I just feel connected. I feel connected to a better part of myself.
But despite that connection and all the success on the track, Frank has suffered greatly from a disconnection off of it. Of his 51 years running, almost all have been spent battling alcohol and drug addiction. Frankie, would you say running is a life preserver for you?
Russ, to be honest with you, I mean, running is really, really important to me. It's a thread that's been to the fabric of my entire life since I've been a kid. But my life support, again, is my relationship with AA, because if I don't have that relationship and I don't maintain sobriety, I don't get to run.
So where did this lifelong battle with addiction begin? Frank begrudgingly refers to his childhood in Chatham, New Jersey, when his 70-year-old brother Nicholas, his protector, was killed in a car accident. Frank was just 12.
I think it had an effect on me. It definitely was a time in my family, you know, Italian-American family. My mother wore black for like 10 years, and it was just a kind of sad time in my house all the time. But I don't see that as a reason why I picked up drugs or alcohol.
Whatever the reason, Frank was a user, but still went on to have a stellar track career at Chatham High School, setting records and garnering some 25 scholarship offers. Places like Princeton and Cornell wanted him, but Frank didn't want them. Instead of going to college, Frank decided to be a landscaper and do drugs.
I'm from the school where you don't have any excuses. I know guys on the track team that I run for, you know, that were born in the ghetto without a mother, without a father, and they've got their own PhDs, and they pursued an education, and they didn't let anything hold them back. So I believe there is no excuse.
Excuses or not, Frank's decision would have devastating effects. After committing robberies to support his heroin habit, Frank spent 4 months behind bars in 1977. When he got out, it was right back to heroin and an overdose. Twice he was given last rites. But Frank battled back, cleaned himself up, and amazingly became a drug counselor and had 15 years of sobriety.
Frank is a very gifted person. He's a gifted athlete, and he's also has an amazing art of communicating and developing rapport with other people. And those skills always enabled Frank to just be a great counselor, and he's a natural born leader.
But according to Robert Budsock, president and CEO of Integrity House, the rehab facility in Newark visited recently by President Obama in November, Frank's leadership was just not enough to keep him running in the right direction.
Frank continued to battle his own demons, which resulted in Frank going in and out of recovery over a period of years.
I don't really think there's anything that can prevent you from going back. If you're going to pick it up, you're going to pick it up, and you have to suffer the consequences. I know guys with wonderful family lives and incredible careers, and Hollywood is calling them, and they can't step away from the drugs or alcohol.
Talk about Hollywood. Frank's story reads like a Hollywood script, one of triumph and despair, running taking him to the top, drugs and alcohol sending him crashing down to the bottom. Fair to say, running is a good addiction taking over for a bad addiction?
Well, I'm glad you asked that question, because to me, the definition of addiction is characterized by harmful consequences. You know, people say, oh, I have a chocolate addiction, but they don't go and stick up a bank to get a chocolate bar. The thing is, addiction has negative consequences. I have never had any negative consequences from my running. I never stole running shoes. I never committed a crime to enable me to run. So calling running an addiction, I disagree with that.
As for those negative consequences of addiction, Frank suffered the worst this past June. Because of a drug deal gone wrong and an ensuing fight, Frank was given a 4-month sentence in Rikers Island.
You're in with killers and rapists and bad people, and they're offering you drugs for free, and you got the willpower at this juncture in your life to say no. Explain that, because it's crazy to me.
To me, it's not willpower. I mean, I don't see it as willpower. I mean, I think that, you know, it's a matter of surrendering to your disease of addiction.
He really went down. I mean, he's had some demons to struggle with and overcome, and he's been down and out. We were really worried about him because he was pretty down deep in the pit.
It's a really miserable existence. I mean, you compromise your values, you compromise what you love. You know, it could be your family, it could be your job. You know, you surrender all that stuff to keep using. It's a very unhappy existence.
Fortunately, right now, Frank is out of the pit. But can he stay out? Maybe, with a new understanding.
Here I was a world record holder, and, you know, I can't go a day without using. You know, and it creates this conflict in yourself, in myself, you know, where I'm really unhappy, and it's almost like schizophrenic. You wonder who you are. Am I the guy that set world records, or am I the guy that's buying drugs now? Who am I? You actually lose myself.
For the time being, though, Frank appears to have found himself, and with his running, is headed in the right direction.
I do the maintenance that I have to do by attending my meetings. I go to aftercare. I see the psychiatrist. So I'm doing everything in the proper steps to not pick up a drink or a drug, and that's the path I'm on. Recovery, I believe, is a path. It's not a destination. You know, it's not like you get to recovery. You travel the path of recovery, and I'm on the path of recovery.
As those in recovery say, one day at a time.
Right now, Frank is currently training others from the elite to the very beginners, and he's also in training himself for what hopes will be a successful return at the historic Penn Relays in April, a meet where he's already won 2 gold medals. But again, it's all about one day at
incredible
a time.
Wow, what a hard won, great perspective he has. Yeah. Amazing. Pretty inspiring
stuff. Interesting guy.
Yeah, thank you, Russ.